This is a Ducati Monster 821, and today I'm gonna review it. Everyone starts with off the engine specifications and the engine power and torque figures, but I'm gonna do it in a different way because every engine nowadays in terms of middleweight or super bikes are most probably making more than 100 horsepower. So, but not every motorcycle has a the same capacity of stopping it from that kind of a speed to zero. So to stop this bike, Ducati has equipped with the Brembo braking, which are the M40 calipers. These are the last third generation, because the M40, then came the M50, and the latest generation is the Stylema calipers. Now, in terms of engine, the engine of this particular bike is a different kind of an engine, because it is an L-twin engine, which is not very common, but it is famous for only the Ducati lineup. All the Ducati lineup till the V4 Panigale has the L-twin engine from since the 1993, from when the Ducati Monster was actually born. It was a L-twin engine of 900cc, but after that they refined it to a 696, then came the 750, then came a 650. Then after refining so many models from past two decades and a half, more than that actually, it ended up as being a Ducati Monster 821. Though in India, there was only 797, which was launched in India. Previously, there was no Monster available in India, and after 797, the next model was the 821. This is the BS4 model, which I am reviewing it, but BS6 is yet to come. I don't know when the Ducati Monster 821 of BS6 model is gonna come. Now, in terms of engine specification, it produces around 110 to 112 bhp and around 78 newton meters of torque. So that is pretty very high numbers as compared to a L-twin engines, because twin cylinders are not capable of producing much of a horsepower. They are more towards the torque figures. That's the main reason why this bike is able to launch or is able to do wheeling every gear, pretty much the first three gears. It does a wheelie. This particular bike is equipped with a Termignoni exhaust, and it is a beautiful one, which is a carbon fiber unit. I was expecting a full system, but slip-on is a very good add on this, because it sounds absolutely beautiful. I just heard it in the basement of the owner's apartment, and it actually sounds pretty good until it cost 1.2 lakhs. Now, for the tires, it is equipped with a Pirelli Diablo Rosso Corsa 3. I mean the Rosso 3, not the Rosso Corsa. These particular tires are very grippy in both dry and wet conditions. The front one is a 120 by 17 inches, and the rear one is a 180 by 55, 17 inches. Now, the instrument cluster of this bike is absolutely beautiful, because Ducati was one of the first motorcycle company to bring out all the TFT displays and fancy gizmos into Indian market. Then came all the Japanese market, because Italians are the first one to bring all the innovative things. So in terms of all the technology that is in this bike, you can see the dash. There is the this here is the mode, the time, the rev meter, the speed, the stand, side stand indicator. It mentions that the ABS is on first level. DTC stands for Ducati Traction Control, which is on third. This is the temperature of the engine, I believe. This is a gear position indicator, and the average is 20.1. my god, that is little shock for me also. 20.1 is a, I mean, it's a pretty good average. I mean, the Duke 390 gives 21, man. So that is a pretty good average for a 821 Monster. And you can see here is the total kilometers of the bike. So in terms of mode, it has sport, touring and urban. Now you can see in the urban that the engine level is low. The Ducati traction control is at maximum level at 6 and ABS at maximum level 3. In touring mode, the engine power is at medium. The Ducati traction control is at 4 and ABS at level 2. When you switch it to sport, that's when the hooligan mode turns on and it basically wheelies at every gear. Now the Monster is a Ducati's entry-level naked sports bike, and this bike has its own charm. Actually, the L-twin thump is it's in a different league. Now, when it was launched, there was only one or two bikes of its competition, like the Street Triple and also the Z800 when it was launched in India. But the Z800 got cancelled and Z900 was introduced. But now the competition is very, very tough, because from its premium segment class, there is the BMW F900R and also the Triumph Street Triple RS and also the new Kawasaki Z900. And there was also KTM Duke 790, but that has been sold out. Only 100 units were bought into India. So the main competition for this bike now is the Kawasaki Z900, the Street Triple RS, and also the BMW F900R. Now when you compare it to the competition, the Kawasaki Z900 is not very nimble, I should say. Now its weight is about 200 kilos and it's not at all very good at cornering. It's not very good at maneuvering the bike in traffic. It's made for only the straight lines, that's all I can say. It's not at all preferable for those who are corner junkies or those who are looking for a city friendly bike which is pretty maneuverable in the city traffic. Then you should definitely avoid this bike. That is not at all preferable in this bike. The other two are the Street Triple RS and the BMW F900R. I have seen a Street Triple RS, but I have never seen an F900R in the real life. So Street Triple RS, I mean, that's the bike which I am very much fond of, because that's the favorite bike of mine in terms of naked sports bikes. And I don't know, man, why it is, because maybe it's because of that inline 3 cylinders. That's the reason why this channel also has a name tag of inline 3, because I love inline 3 engines. The engine is what differentiates that bike. Though the MV Agusta 800RR is there in the Indian market, I'm not considering it, because you can get two Street Triple R for that price. I mean, the price of MV Agusta 800RR in Bangalore is around 22 lakhs, and you can get two F900R almost. Two BMW F900R for that price. That is not at all an ideal choice whenever you are buying a bike, unless you want to buy that bike and keep it as a showpiece in your home. That's preferable. And Street Triple RS has everything, man. You have Ohlins back suspension, you have Showa suspension, fully adjustable Brembo M50 calipers, the electronics, ride-by-wire, steel braided lines, thicker tires, everything it has. And the looks is absolutely killing. I don't know who hates the looks. Every YouTuber says this in his video, that the looks are subjective. Some people don't like it, some people like it. I don't know who are those some people who don't like it. You need to change your taste, man. That's all I can say. This bike, I mean, the 3RRR just looks absolutely a beauty, man. This is absolutely a beauty, I should say. And the BMW F900R, I have not seen much of it. All that I know is this is a parallel twin engine producing about 110 horsepower, and the electronics is what makes this bike, I mean, I should say. The console is straight out of the S1000RR, their flagship super sport, and it looks awesome. The TFT looks awesome, the electronics are awesome. I mean, BMW has the best electronics in the motorcycle game, that's all I can say. And there is cruise control, there is everything in this bike in terms of electronics and also in terms of equipment. This bike is also very, very good at looks, though not at the level of the Monster and Street Triple RS. I should say it is pretty decent. I can give it a 7.5 out of 10. It's a pretty good looking bike, and in terms of performance also it's well equal to the bikes, though it is a bit though it makes a bit less power considering the competition, but it's more than efficient, man. That's all I can say. Now, the final verdict of what I can say is whenever you are buying a middleweight sport bike in terms of naked segment, there are only three choices now because the Ducati Monster is not on sale. But if you want to get it on a used market, it is pretty much available around 8 to 10 lakhs. That's the price that people ask in whenever you search in OLX or other online market or even in the offline market. Now, what I prefer is the Street Triple RS because of its inline 3 engine and the electronics and the design, everything. I mean, it's the lightest bike in the segment, guys. That's all I can say. It weighs around 166 kilos dry. Even the wet weight is around 178 kilos. That is, the 166 kilos is, I mean, I should say it is in Duke 390 category because even the Duke 390 weighs 166 kilos. You can see how much it can be in terms of performance because people with a Duke 390 they are called squids when they ride it fast. Imagine what if they get the Street Triple RS in their hands. I mean, same weight, but the power is almost thrice. I mean, imagining that is also a very, very big thing because the Street Triple RS is a very, very, very balanced bike. Now, that's all with this video, guys, and hope you have enjoyed this video, and make sure you subscribe to my channel. I will be bringing more videos like this, and peace. Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. This video is going to be a review of a pretty special bike because this is my first higher CC capacity motorcycle that I have ridden, and the first motorcycle that I am reviewing in my channel. So if I make any mistakes, please excuse me. And there is a lot of mistakes in this video, but I promise you that I will not repeat it, and I will make sure that I will improve in my future videos and never repeat these mistakes.